It's one thing to set a bold vision, form a plan, summon the resources at your disposal, and muster the courage to found an organization that constantly takes risks by creating new art. And it's another thing entirely, having done this comprehensive work, to reinvent your budding enterprise midstream. That's exactly what Katherine FitzGibbon has done with Resonance Ensemble. 8 years into her artistic venture, FitzGibbon decided to rededicate Resonance to performing concerts promoting meaningful social change. This shift meant a concerted effort to ensure that marginalized voices were being heard in key conversations and decisions, including a major upheaval in the composition of the organization's leadership, and amplifying those voices through the addition of a poet in residence, S. Renee Mitchell. The totality of Resonance's transformation is crystal clear from one look at their current season: concerts on voices of color, babies born with birth defects, and the female experience, including a commission from composer Melissa Dunphy, setting text from Senate testimony given by Anita Hill and Christine Blasey Ford. The performances that FitzGibbon produces aren't your typical concerts. For starters, most are held in Portland's more diverse neighborhoods rather than traditional downtown venues to better serve the full breadth of Portland. She invites community partners into the long-term planning process for each event, often leading to artistic collaborations, which have included Pride Northwest and the El Sistema-inspired Bravo Youth Orchestra. Under her vision, Resonance's budget has grown almost tenfold since its inception a decade ago, and FitzGibbon has consistently prioritized paying her singers a competitive wage. Katherine FitzGibbon reminds us that we can always choose to adjust our course. We salute her fearlessness with the 2019 Louis Botto Award.